The Southwest African country of Angola has encountered massive infrastructure demands since the end of the civil war. China is now in a leading role helping the Angolan people. Wu Lei reports.
During the past years, the Angolan government has spent tens of billions of U.S. dollars on housing projects, among which the Kilamba Kiaxi project is the largest one. Jado and his wife moved into this 150 square meter house in Kilamba in 2013.
The living conditions here are much better than my previous house because all the buildings are new and life is very ordered. This is an open city with many green belts.
Jado and 85,000 other residents are living in Kilamba City. Since October 2012, the previously rural area has turned into a bustling satellite city, covering 8.8 square kilometers with over 20,000 homes. The Angolan government also appointed Joachim Israel Marcus as the first mayor of Kilamba. He said at present over 95% of the houses are filled.
We have 24 kindergartens, 17 public schools, 9 primary and 8 secondary schools. We have a sewage treatment plant. We have 2 electrical substations. We have roads, telecommunications, landscape. All this infrastructure was done for the project.
CITIC Construction's Executive General Manager Zhu Boxue said they were able to finish the largest housing project on the African continent on schedule because of their team approach, which he called the combined fleet model.
In our combined fleet, different companies with different strengths are united to maximize their talents. For example, CITIC Construction is responsible for the whole commercial organizing, while our construction companies build all the houses, and logistic companies shipped over 4 million tons of domestic building materials. We have developed a creative business model for this project.
CITIC Construction also founded a vocational school in Kilamba in 2014, providing for impoverished city youth from the ages of 16 to 24. Most students at the school take courses in electrical and mechanical engineering, the most needed skills in the post-war reconstruction process. This May, the school for the first time recruited 16 female Angolan students to study hotel management. The school is also supported by the Angolan and Chinese governments.
In the future, the CITIC Bainian Vocational School will be operated and managed by local staff. Localization is a must, offering a good platform for their education.
Encouraged by its success in Kilamba, the company is now working with other Angolan cities to construct similar housing projects. It is also trying to replicate its experience in more African countries, including Kenya, Rwanda, and Nigeria.
Chinese companies have played a key role in Angola's post-war reconstruction. Under the framework of the China-Angola bilateral cooperation, many Chinese enterprises have actively participated in the rebuilding process.
Through planning, financing, and post-construction operation, CITIC Construction built an entire city while also creating a whole operational industry chain and a skilled labor team for future development.
President Dos Santos held the Satellite City project as a model for Angola's post-war reconstruction. It displays high quality and standards of Chinese companies. Both sides say previous experience will help deepen bilateral cooperation in other fields, including agriculture, manufacturing, and service sectors in the years to come. CCTV, Kilamba in Angola.